Hey everybody, what's going on? Paul here. Today I'm answering one of your questions that I got on Instagram. And that question is, I can't seem to get anything done. Do you have any tips for becoming more productive? So I'm gonna answer that momentarily. But first, do me a favor, show me some love, hit that like button below. Now let's dive in and I wanna give you my top 10 tips for developing superhuman productivity. So tip number one is create the right environment and eliminate distractions. Now, everybody is more productive in certain environments. If you are, let's say, a writer, you're someone who needs inspiration from your environment, working in a public place might be beneficial. If you're trying to write a book, though, and you need to concentrate, you might need a quiet corner of the house or the library. Figure out what it is you're trying to achieve and identify the environment in which you're going to thrive the most. Now, the second half to that is eliminating distractions. What's your number one distraction? It's probably going to be your phone. Turn your phone off, put it in another room, eliminate the distraction. You can always go and check your phone later. You can check Facebook, Instagram, emails later on. Get rid of that stuff right now because it's totally getting in the way of your productivity. Would you rather achieve your goals or would you rather check Instagram? That one's up to you. I'd recommend turning the phone off, putting it in a different room, or even better, set the alarm for 30, 45, 60 minutes when you want to take a break and put it in another room. Once you hear that alarm go off, it's break time. But until that alarm goes off, you're super focused on your work. Tip number two, if you want to develop superhuman productivity, is to identify the end goal and learn to reverse engineer it. So let's say what we want to do is lose 20 pounds. If that's our end goal, we need to reverse engineer how we're going to do that. So our end goal, our start point. What do we have to do in order to achieve that goal? Well, 90 days, meaning we probably want to work out 4 or 5 days a week. So you're going to create a plan 4 to 5 days a week where you're going to work out. You need 3 good meals a day, but they need to be healthy. So 90 times 3 is 270 meals. So you're going to schedule in healthy meals and you're going to come up with a plan to actually make those healthy meals. That's reverse engineering. You have your final goal and you ask yourself, what are the things I need to do from now till then to get myself to that goal? So whether it's trying to lose weight, write a book, start a business, what's the end goal? Where are you at? And what specific things do you need to do along the way to get to that goal? When you do this, you're not just going at it willy-nilly. You're actually coming up with a strategic plan. You're writing it out, and then all you need to do is execute on a daily basis. If you're having trouble becoming productive, doing this alone will get you so many more results than if you just sort of dive in and hope for the best. My tip number three for developing superhuman productivity is to schedule your day from start to finish. This means I want you to create an hour-by-hour plan of everything you need to do to accomplish the goals or move towards the goals that you want to accomplish in the future. Why is this so important? Because a structured day-by-day, hour-by-hour plan ensures that you're actually doing the things that you need to do to help you chip away at your goals. If you just wake up and you say, today I'm gonna do this or I'm gonna do that, you don't have a plan. You're just hoping that you do these things. But if you write it out hour by hour and then you diligently stick to that plan, you know that every day you're moving closer and closer towards your goals. That is a huge, huge important step to becoming super productive. Tip number four for developing superhuman productivity, and this one is really key, is learning how to get into flow state. Flow state is very simple to understand. Flow state is when you get in the zone. Getting in the zone is when nothing around you seems to matter. You're zeroed in, you're laser targeted on the task at hand. You need to figure out how to get yourself into that flow state as soon as possible, because when you get into flow state, your productivity is 10x'd. You get so much more done, so you can get 10 times more work done in the same amount of time. That is not only productivity, but that is superhuman productivity. How do we get into flow state though? Well, there's books written on this topic. You can go to YouTube, check long videos about how to get into flow state. For me, what works is simply sticking to a very structured plan and knowing that when I sit down, I've got 30 to 45 minutes of intense work, and then my alarm goes off, and then I take a break. This is called the Pomodoro Technique, and I strongly recommend you look into the Pomodoro Technique because it really can help you focus, especially if you're prone to distractions. The Pomodoro Technique is simple. You set the alarm for 30 minutes, let's say, put it aside, and then you start working. Now, one of the reasons we get distracted is because if we don't have a structured plan to what we're going to do, we just think, oh, I have so much to do. And then you get sort of this antsiness to go do other things. So what you do is you go to YouTube, you go to Facebook. Before you know it, you spent 30 minutes on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, whatever. But if you set an alarm and you say, I have 30 minutes and then I can take a break, it allows you to realize and to sort of let go of all the other stuff and just focus at the task at hand. When you do that, you're going to get into flow state so easily that your alarm's going to go off, and you might consider just hitting the snooze and sticking with it. It's hard to really understand it unless you actually try it. So I strongly recommend looking into the Pomodoro technique, implementing it, and you're going to notice that you get into this state where you're zoned in, getting more done in less time and with more ease. That is a huge key to developing superhuman productivity. Tip number 5 is very, very simple. Do not multitask. Science has shown us again and again that multitasking is actually detrimental to productivity. We've been hearing this for years and years and years. You need to learn to multitask, multitask, multitask. Complete garbage. Multitasking, all it does is it takes your attention from one thing to the next before you've actually accomplished something. So if you have 3 things to do all day, don't try to do them all at once. Focus on one thing, get it done. Then focus on the next thing, get it done. Then focus on the next thing, get it done. Because if you try to multitask, what's going to happen is your brain is going to just put into overdrive. You're going to have trouble concentrating and focusing, and you're going to be distracted. You're going to want to go and look at Facebook or Instagram or YouTube because you're driving yourself nuts because you're not getting anywhere. So stop multitasking. Create your daily structured plan and then do one thing at a time. Might seem like it's not as productive, but trust me, you'll start to tick things off your list. That is how you develop superhuman productivity. Tip number 6 for developing superhuman productivity is to stay healthy and stay hydrated. It doesn't matter how motivated you are, how inspired you are. If you're not maintaining your health, you're simply not going to be executing at the highest level. Your brain needs to be properly fueled. Your body needs to feel good and energized. The way you do that is just eat a healthy diet and exercise regularly. Don't overcomplicate it. Just avoid junk food. Avoid fried foods. Avoid all the crap that you know you shouldn't be eating. Even if you are executing at a fairly high level and you eat a really crappy diet and you're not exercising, you could be doing 2 to 3 times better with a good diet. And one of the other important things is to stay hydrated, right? Drink your water. Water is super important because it keeps your brain feeling fresh, keeps your body feeling fresh. And when you're hydrated, you can just execute at a much higher level. Dehydration, even just the smallest amount, has been scientifically proven to decrease performance, whether you're playing basketball, football, studying, or writing a book. Hydration is so key to your performance that if you're not properly hydrated, you're simply not executing at the highest level. And if you're like me and you want to achieve great things, you need to make sure that everything is where it needs to be to ensure that you can execute at the highest level. So stay hydrated, eat healthy, exercise every single day. It will make a massive difference in your productivity. Tip number 7 for developing superhuman productivity, and this is my absolute favorite, is find your magic time. What is magic time? Magic time is something that I learned from Craig Ballantyne, and magic time is that little window during the day when you seem to be able to get a ton of work done. For me, magic time is between 4 a.m. and 8 a.m. You're thinking, 4 a.m.? Yes, 4 a.m. I get up at 4 a.m. and I start my work. I start chipping away at my to-do list at 4 a.m. And here's the great thing. By 8 a.m., when my dogs wake up and they come running down the stairs, I've got 90 to 95% of everything I must do for the day done. That opens up my entire day to either get more done so that I can advance further and further along the path to my goals, or it allows me to do things like hang out with my friends if it's a weekend or go see my family. Magic time, this is my favorite productivity tool, has been a game changer for me. It allows you to get everything done before the rest of the world wakes up. Now, if you can't wake up early, that's okay. I'd recommend you at least give it a shot. Try it for 2 to 3 months. I think you'll find a huge difference. But we can have magic time any time of day. And what you need to do to figure out when your magic time is just test it out. Is your magic time from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m.? Maybe it's late at night. I know some people get a lot done from, let's say, 9 p.m. to 1 a.m. Just play around and figure out what that little window during the day is when you can get the majority of your work done in less time. If you can tap into this concept of a magic time, you'll get more done in less time, which either gives you more freedom to do other things that you want or more freedom to advance your agenda to achieving your goals that much faster. Tip number 8 for developing superhuman productivity is to batch or chunk similar activities together. Just give you a quick example. For me, I like to film YouTube videos and I make Instagram content. I will typically put out 2 to 3 Instagram videos a week and 1 YouTube video a week. How do I use tip number 8 to achieve this goal? I film everything on a single day. So Monday morning, I'll wake up with my entire list of what I need to film and I'll film it. Tuesday, I will do all of the editing. So Monday I film, Tuesday I edit. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and then into the next week, I've done all that work. I don't have to worry about it. This allows you to be more productive in other areas of your life. So consider chunking or batching similar activities, whatever it is you're trying to achieve together. It will help you develop not only superhuman productivity, but it'll allow you to be much, much more efficient so that you can do other things with your life. Tip number 9 for developing superhuman productivity is to always focus on doing the most important thing first. What does this mean? Well, it means what is the biggest, most important thing you need to do every day to really move the ball forward towards your goals. Do that first. I typically like to combine this concept with the magic time. So if I wake up at 4 a.m. and today I need to make sure I film this particular video, I'm gonna get up and I'm gonna do that first, because putting out the video is what allows me to build my audience. That's super important to me. So do whatever the most important thing you need to do first thing when you wake up, or first thing when you actually start working on your business, your side project, whatever it may be. Do the most important thing first, or another way to look at this is do the thing that you wanna do least first. Get it out of the way. Because typically, if you don't do the thing you don't wanna do first, you're gonna leave it to the end of the day, and then it sort of rolls into the next day. Before you know it, a week's gone by, you haven't done what you need to do. Focus on the most important thing first, get it done with, and then move on. And the final tip, tip number 10 to developing superhuman productivity, is to say no and to delegate tasks. So what do I mean by this? Well, saying no means saying no to things like social outings or things that simply won't advance you towards your goals. So if people are asking you to do this or to do that and it's not going to help you achieve your personal goals, don't be afraid to say no. Because when you say yes to everything, it takes you away from the most important things for you. Now, this doesn't mean say no to everything. It just means say no to the things that don't serve you and don't help you advance your own agenda. The next part is to delegate tasks. Now, that doesn't really need that much of an explanation. Delegate the tasks that can be done by someone else to someone else. Now, for you, if you are, let's say, filming videos and you need to be on the video, you can't delegate that. What you can delegate, though, is the editing. Because if you delegate something like editing, which can be done by anybody who can edit, then gives you more time to maybe create more videos or to do other things that help you move towards your goals. Delegate the tasks that someone else can do to them. Focus on doing the things that you need to do that only you can do. That will get you towards your goals much faster and allow the other work that other people can do get done so that it can help you snowball the effects of your efforts. So there you go. Those are my top 10 tips to developing superhuman productivity. At the end of the day, if you want to achieve big things, you have to learn to be productive every single day. What I just gave you is the blueprint for developing superhuman productivity. So hopefully that was helpful. If it was, please hit the like button below and do not forget to subscribe. I release new videos every single week. Thank you all for stopping by. See you on the next episode. Hey, thanks for tuning in. I hope that was a helpful video. I've got a couple more great options. We got one here. We've got one here.